As most of you know, Spotify is one of the most popular streaming applications out there. And I'll give you a quick breakdown on exactly how to use this particular application. Now, luckily for you, Spotify isn't a super complicated application to use. So by the end of this, you should have a really good understanding on how to use this particular app. Now, to get started, this is what the application looks like. It's Spotify Music and Podcasts. Now, when you first boot it up, you'll be asked to create an account or sign into your account. So you can go ahead and create your account or sign into your account depending on what you've already done. If you've already created it, then you're set. If you haven't, then you can go and basically create your account this way. And when you log in, you'll basically come into this page. Now you're going to see a lot of stuff. You're going to see, it's going to be kind of information overload, but if I break down to the very top, you'll kind of get an idea of how it works. So the very top of this application, you're going to see your user profile icon right here. So when you tap on it, it'll give you into your profile. You can swipe back out. You'll see a couple of different branches of things that you can listen to. So you can get into everything that's basically on Spotify, just to your music, just podcasts, and just audiobooks. And you can get a glimpse if you want to break down a little bit quicker and exactly what you want to kind of filter down to. At the very top, there'll be kind of like, a recommendation list of different songs and different things that you have. If you have shared playlists or shared things with other people, or if you have a playlist that you like listening to, those types of things will show up here. As you can see, I have this Drake mix right up here. And then pretty much the main page is just new updates, new songs, new albums, and different things that Spotify thinks you'll like. It'll go and show up right here. To be honest, I don't really use it like on an everyday basis, but it's still kind of nice to kind of go throughout here and kind of see what else is going on. And you can kind of go through and get an idea of exactly what's going on within Spotify and new types of songs and new types of playlists that are going to be coming out. Now that's it for this portion. At the very bottom, this little tab right here will basically be songs that you're listening to. If this is a song you're listening to, that little bracket will come up right here. So it's just a little like a bucket thing, as they'll just show you whatever song you're listening to, and you can click on it to kind of show what song you're listening to in more detail. Now I'll pull up that in a second. At the very top, at the very bottom, you can see a few more things that are going on. You have your home tab, so this is the home tab we were just in. You have a search bar right here. So you can click on the search bar and you can actually pull up songs that you're basically listening to, or you can search for really anything within Spotify. So within search, there's a little search bar right up here. So you can go and type in a song that you want to, there's a specific song you want to listen to. You can click onto there and you can search for that song. At the very top right, you can also pull up a camera. So you can also scan a code if you want. If there's a code within Spotify to pull up a song, some indie artists have this. You can also just pull up a song straight up just by scanning it there, which is pretty cool. This is a kind of a, again, more categories of different things that you can kind of pull into. So you have music, podcasts, audiobooks, and live events. So you can kind of go through here and kind of choose different things that you like here too. That's another really cool thing. There's also different genres that you can have within Spotify. So those specific genres will show up right here as well. So you'll also be able to kind of configure that a little bit further. And you can also browse all, but if you want to search for a song, you can just search for a song this way. You can pull up whatever artist you like. So if you like Drake or whatever, you can pull up this particular artist like this, and you'll be able to see all the songs that this particular musical artist plays. Now, if you want to, there's songs, there's playlist. It's all broken down here for you. So if there's a specific song you want, you can pull it up this way. You can also go inside of their direct page this way, and you'll be able to see the particular artist, their page. There's concerts coming out in your area, new albums, new songs. You'll be able to see all that information here. At the very bottom, you'll see other similar artists and similar songs as well. So that's another really cool thing that you have. Now at the bottom, you'll see another Your Library tab, which is the third tab at the very bottom. So now what you can do is you can tap onto Your Library this way, and you'll see a massive list of all the different songs and different categories of people that you can listen to. Now, if you have liked songs, if you have playlist builds, if you have anything like that, you'll see all those songs right inside of this area. At the very top, you can go and click on the plus button, and you can create a new playlist or you can create a blend. A playlist is just a composition of all the songs and different things that you have. So you can create a playlist this way, you can name it whatever you want to, and kind of go down this direction. You can also click on the plus button and you can do blend. So you can click blend and you can also, invite a different friend to create a blend for you as well. So that's another really cool thing that you have. At the bottom right, it just shows you some things of Spotify Premium. So if you want to get into Spotify Premium, if you want to purchase it, which I'd probably recommend it if you want to use Spotify, it's like $12 a month. They're probably going to increase it now, but that's another thing you can do too. Now, when you're actually playing a song, you'll see this is what it looks like. So when you're playing the song, this is the list it'll look like. There's a couple of different options here too. So you can hop out of a song just by swiping it down or clicking on the top left. You'll see the name of the song, the person who made the song right here too. You can also click on the plus and minus if you want to go and add the song to a particular playlist if you want to. You can also delete it if it has a checkmark that means it's in that song or that playlist. Now you have a play button. If you have Spotify pre, you basically, or free, you basically have this, you know, next button, you can't go back in it. You can share the song by clicking the share button on the bottom right corner. You can share the song wherever you want to. You can even swipe up and you'll see the lyrics of the song. As you can see, I guess you can't even load up, but you can see more artist information and so many things across the board here too. You can swipe back down if you want to hop out of it. And the bottom left, if you want to share, play it, or, you know, play it somewhere else, you can also do that here too. So it's a really cool thing. That's at core how to use Spotify. Like I said, there's not anything super crazy going on here. It's a very basic app to use. And once you use it, you'll get more and more used to it over time. So that's basically how it's done. It's a super basic process. If you have any other thoughts or questions, please let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button. That would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.